In the currency dimension of an analytic model, or the organization dimension of a planning model, we can set the source currency for each dimension member. If we need to import data in different currencies and aggregate those values together, we need to enable currency conversion in the model preferences. The default currency is the one the various source currencies will be converted to. We can change it if necessary. Next, we need to specify the dimension that contains the currency information. This is selected automatically unless our model contains more than one currency dimension, in which case we need to choose the one to use. Next, we need to choose the currency rates table in SAP Analytics Cloud that contains the exchange rates to use. Note that we can't choose a different table after data has been imported to the model. However, we can update the values in the table either manually or by scheduling to add new rows as conversion rates change. Refer to the video on creating and managing currency tables for details. We also need to choose the dimension that contains the dates we want to use when determining which conversion rates to use. In this case, the model contains only one date dimension. Next, we have the option to enable pre-converted actuals. This allows us to import values in different source currencies and also import the actuals values already converted into the model's default currency, rather than using the exchange rates in the currency conversion table to perform the calculations. Note that the currency conversion table is still used for versions other than actuals. Refer to the video on importing pre-converted actuals for details. Finally, we need to specify the maximum currency conversion limit, which sets the number of additional currency conversions that can be displayed simultaneously in tables based on the model. In this case, we'll use the default value of 4. Now, we'll save the changes to the model preferences. When we enable currency conversion, new member details are available in the version and account dimensions, where we need to apply the appropriate settings. Note that analytic models don't contain a version dimension. In the account dimension, a rate type column has been added. Each account with an account type specified needs to be assigned a corresponding rate type. Income and expense account types should use the average rate type, and asset and liability account types should use the closing rate type. In the currency conversion table, we can maintain separate average and closing conversion rates for the same currencies and time periods if we want. Similarly, in the version dimension, a rate version column has been added, where we can choose to use a specific rate version from the currency table rather than the standard rate for the selected category. For example, we might create separate optimistic and pessimistic rate versions to simulate scenarios where exchange rates change dramatically in the future. In this case, we won't choose a rate version. Now that our model is set up appropriately for currency conversion, we'll save it. The model has been updated. Thanks for watching.